which means really two things. Studio 10 is live right throughout January. Yay! A little game called the cricket. While it might be considered our national sport, there are plenty of us who don't know our googly from our LBW, right?
Yay!
Wrongin.
Oh, get it?
If you didn't get that joke, which I didn't, Mamma Mia, they've come up with a really handy guide on how to fake a cricket conversation this summer. Let's bring in our cricketing guru, our king of spin, Robbo.
Well, Sarah, I'm at the cricket ground on top of it. Sarah, just... Is that what men drink? This morning, I want to pass on some of my cricket knowledge to our viewers with some simple terms, phrases and keywords that they can drop in at a BBQ and everyone will assume you are a walking wisdom. Now, wisdom, that's not a typo there, Sarah, darling. No, no, that's the cricketing rule book for those of you who didn't know. Now, first tip to faking cricket knowledge, and, you know, a lot of girls are used to faking it, is to talk about the wicket and comment on the pitch. Now, one tip to fake it is ask question. And here's a handy phrase, remember, come in here, mate. Now, you ask your mate at a barbecue, you say, do you think the dry and cracked sticky wicket will mean we see lots of bounces? Ah, off you go, mate. And you always pat them on the bum when they go out. That's how you do it. Hey, mate. They're so shocked at the pat on the bum that they won't even recognise that you haven't said anything with any kind of knowledge about it. So there you go. Ding dong,
what other tips have you got for cricketing dummies?
Well, g'day, ding dong, you beautiful woman. Great to see you down at the cricket as well. Now, talk about bowling. That's when one player throws his ball at the player with the stick in his hand. Stick in his hand. That's what we're talking about. Now, you drop in words like spin, flipper, warnie and finger spinner. Oh. And you'll be the life of any cricket conversation.
Sounds a bit... Look, I reckon if you've got to talk cricket, you should be getting new friends. But, Robbo, what should I talk about if someone wants to talk to me about a cricket bat?
Oh, Andy, good to see you. Know you love the cricket and the balls. Lovely to see you here, mate. Now, you'll be batting above your average with these key phrases. How nice was that cut shot? That was some solid blocking. And one of my favourites, he played that right up the cow corner.
Now, Robbo, the other thing with cricket, of course, is all these weird acronyms. Now, can you explain what an LBW is?
Joe, mate, you've come to the right person. LBW, of course, means lunch before wine. But I try... I seem to have broken the rules. Richie will be right up my bum for that one. Now, what you need to remember is if you're planning to spend some time in the harsh summer sun, you want to have your fluids up. But in the cricketing world, an LBW is leg before wicket. Now, nobody knows what that actually means. Not even the Channel 9 commentators, not even the great people here at 10 who are doing the Big Bash League. But here's my tip. Just shout, how's that? And yeah! When anything happens, and you'll be safe. If not, pat your friends on the bum and it'll do the same thing.
Look, Robbo, I watch cricket and I've never got a clue who's winning, who's bad. I don't know any of it. How can we tell who's actually winning?
Well, Andy, you are on the right tip there, my friend. Asking who is winning is something to be avoided. It's the first sign... You've got no idea what you're talking about. As any cricket fan will tell you, it is not whether you win or lose, but how the game is played. And coincidentally, that's how I think of every time after the Logies that I go. Still waiting for an invite. But, you know, that's what you're going to do. And remember, if you're playing cricket, make sure you wear your box.
That is just not cricket. Robbo, thank you very much for joining us. Better get back to the ground. Thank you. Okay.